Chafflining is another harvest weed seed control system. It's the newest kid on the block. It was developed by grain growers in Esperance. It's widely used by grain grower Mick Fells. He says he didn't invent it, but he has been one of the promoters of this system. It's the cheapest system, but it's also a system that we probably know the least about. But it looks quite encouraging, and I think it really may have a good fit in some areas in Australian cropping. So what is chaff lining? It's a little bit like the chaff tram lining system, but instead of putting the weed seeds on the wheel tracks, we are putting the chaff in a narrow strip in the middle of the harvester. So we are just putting the weed seeds there in that chaff fraction, not the straw, just the chaff, and leaving it there. So it's a little bit of a different concept. There's not a lot of science behind it, but it does look quite encouraging for growers that are using it. Also, it's best suited to control traffic farming. So really it's about putting that weed seed bearing chaff in the same place every year on top of each other, where the weeds can, if they do grow, can compete with each other in that line. But what we find is that we feel that we're getting some rotting of the weed seeds, and some weed seeds germinate and die before their roots reach the ground. And also some weed seeds may just remain dormant and never germinate at all. So what we've seen from growers using this system, and as I've said, we don't have any scientific data, but what we've seen is these chaff lines are often not terribly weedy, which is really quite surprising. The reason that growers got into this instead of putting it on their wheel tracks, well, one of the reasons is that they feel that by putting the chaff in the middle of the harvester, they're not running over it, so they're not stimulating a germination of weeds. And from reports that I've heard from growers in Esperance that are using it, it's quite common for them to have the chaff line in the middle with not many weeds on it, but some weeds germinating on their tram lines just from the harvester running over it. So the fact that these chaff lines are just left and not run over could possibly stimulate greater seed decay. Growers are just making the shoots themselves. This is a shoot made by a grower, Leigh, Bryan. He adopted this purely from Twitter. He saw what other growers were doing. He got on Twitter, asked them how they set it up, and the growers talked him through it just on Twitter. And at the end of the day, he had a chaff shoot made and went chaff lining. So amazing effort that this grower just managed to adopt chaff lining just through the use of social media. As with some of the other systems where we're just talking about the chaff fraction, growers are often fitting a baffle. It depends on the make of harvester. Some harvesters are already good at separating chaff and straw, but some harvesters benefit from a baffle to maximise the weed seeds that end up in that chaff line. So as I said, we've observed that we're not ending up with super weedy chaff lines in many situations. We believe that some of the weeds are rotting, but as I said, we haven't really had any science. But the chaff line in this picture here wasn't sown. There was a mistake made with the driving of the seeder, and this particular chaff line wasn't sown. But that chaff line has weed seeds in it, and there was very little germination of weeds in that chaff line. So from what we've observed so far, weeds just don't like growing in chaff, and there's also moisture retention and like a compost rotting effect going on. So the initial signs are very positive, but we do need to add some science to understand this a bit more. And there's another great option where a grower perhaps could use chaff lining in their cereal phase, and then when they come to a canola crop, make a conventional windrow with all of the straw and chaff, and then burn that windrow and set the system back to zero again. So by putting the chaff line in the same place every year, if it starts getting weedy, there is the option to do this and remove those weed seeds that are in that narrow strip. The chaff lining is easily the cheapest harvest weed seed control system. There's almost no capital cost. Growers are making the chaff shoots themselves. There is no burning cost. There's nothing to do after harvest. So to do at harvest, it is the cheapest system. There is, of course, the residue removal cost, because we are taking some residue and putting it in the chaff line, perhaps 15% of the residue in the paddock. So we do have to account for that residue removal cost, which, as for the other techniques that involve chaff, is around about that $2.25 per tonne of wheat harvested. So the benefits of chaff lining, it's very low cost, there's nothing to do after harvest, and there's the ability to destroy the weed seeds that are in that chaff line with a future narrow windrow burn, perhaps in a canola crop. And some of the cons of chaff lining, well, as I've said, we don't really have much science to add to the observations. So there's no data that's evaluated the effectiveness of it and to evaluate how much weed seed rotting we're getting. The weed seeds are still in the paddock, so it's not as good as destroying them. It only suits controlled traffic farm growers. And the residue potentially could build up in time. If we go and put that residue there year after year, we could end up with a high level of residue, and perhaps that could create some sort of a problem. There's potential issues with seeding into it. Having said that, most growers are saying they're not a problem to seed through, but if it built up in time, potentially there could be stubble handling issues. And it does create a high seed bank in those areas. So for a weed with a long seed bank, perhaps wild radish, it could be a negative that we end up with this narrow strip of a high seed bank. If the grower wanted to move their tram lines at any point, they could be left with a high seed bank strip of a weed that with a long seed bank that could last for quite a long time. So chaff lining is a great fit for controlled traffic farm growers, probably best suited to farmers with disc seeders. Having said that, growers with tine seeders are using the system to great effect and not having big problems, but probably a really good fit for disc seeders. And let's watch this space for more data. It's a new kid on the block. We haven't had time to measure it scientifically yet. Observations are currently good, but we just haven't had time to add that science to it. In summary, chaff lining, it's the new kid on the block. It's the lowest cost system out there. It's very easy for growers to do themselves and could be a really good tool. I see it as a really good fit for some growers, perhaps even in the high rainfall area where they're already using narrow windrow burning in their pulse and canola crops, but in their cereal crops, they're not doing any harvest weed seed control. They could potentially add chaff lining in those cereal crops and then continue with the narrow windrow burning that they've already been doing. So look, it could be a really good fit, and it's a good one where growers can knock up a chaff shoot on their own and get into it. So chaff lining, not a great deal of science done on this technique yet, but the observations so far have been very good.